स्टैंडर्ड 9th ज्योग्राफी अर्बनाइजेशन वी आर इन द सेकंड लेक्चर यस्टरडे वी सॉ इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी सॉ दैट हाउ अर्बनाइजेशन स्टार्टेड टू इंक्रीज इन इंडिया व्हाट वर द रीजंस फॉर द इंक्रीज इन अर्बनाइजेशन एंड टेंटेटिवली गोइंग थ्रू वन वाज इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन और गिविंग प्रेफरेंस टू ट्रेड पर्टिकुलरली इन द बिगिनिंग एज वी स्टडी We can come to know that in 1961 there were only 78.79% or people engaged in urbanization. Urban centers in India in 1961 recorded by the government were 2,270. Slowly after that up to 1991 it rise up to 25. That means there was a rise of only 8% in 30 years. In 30 years there was a rise of 8%. Whereas urban centers increased to 3,600. But in 1991, because of the new economic policies adopted by India under the leadership of P.V. Narasimha Rao, we come to know that the trend of urbanization started to increase. It gathered momentum. Reasons for that definitely we will study. But from 1991 onwards, which was only up to 25%, In 2001, it rose to 28%, and then we see a hike in urbanization, which in 2011 rose to 37.7%, and the centers rising up to 7,935. Now, because of open economic policy, as we say, because of globalization, because of the change in the whatever the economic policies government adopted, or particularly instead of urbanization, industrialization was given the boost. Foreign disinvestment or foreign investment was poured into India, which generated employment. Generation of employment suddenly changed the tide in favor of urban centers. Even now, that is in 2011, if we try to understand the other side, we come to know that 67% people are engaged in agricultural activities. The other side is that the people engaged in agricultural activities, which is the primary sector, product of the primary sector, its investment, that is investment in agriculture, is more, it's time consuming, it takes more time, and yet dividends or profits is less as compared to secondary and tertiary sector. So naturally, people who were too close to the city lines, that is the adjacent villages, yesterday we saw how a center blooms into a multiple or mega city, and because of this, people from the adjacent villages or areas from where they come to the city to get education, after that are not ready to go back to the villages. Instead, they struggle in the city life. Not everyone can get one and the same employment or as they deserve, but while doing so, it comes to our notice that they are ready to adjust themselves in the cities. There are various reasons. Yesterday we saw that because of the medical facilities, because of the education, because of the transportation, because of the electricity, because of various commodities provided by the municipal corporation to the people. People at large favor to live in cities, that is urban centers. So that was one. There is a fact, there is a fashion living in the city life. City lives are also again divided into, some of them are the best areas of the city, heart of the city as we call them, and some are slum-like areas. Now, starting with the reasons, first we come to know that in the second five-year plan, India gave impetus to industrialization. That was the beginning of urbanization. Industrialization was to be given boost. Bhakra and Nandal, the dams constructed on the river Satluj, Haryana and Punjab, proved to be of utmost importance to Punjab and Haryana, converting it into the storehouse of India. But because of this also, the economic conditions started to rise, and it's one example. Similar examples can be seen throughout India where dams were constructed for irrigation purposes. Because of this, though for irrigation, water was also reserved. So reservoirs were constructed, and these reservoirs, where the water is reserved for, definitely as a potable water, apart from that for agriculture, that is as we call it irrigation, and then for industrialization. The MIDCs, as we spoke in the previous lectures, all the MIDCs in Maharashtra or Industrial Development Corporation of India needs water, and it becomes the important amenities, facility provided by the government. So naturally, all these favored urbanization. Industries started to be set up. Small scale industries, middle or even big cottage industries as we call them, whatever it may be. But government propagated, government gave support to all such industries. And because of that, slowly industries started to increase in India. These industries provided employment opportunities to many. For this, educational facilities were also provided, educational system was transported through technological mechanization, industries needed skilled labors. So technicians were created. IIT yesterday or day before, means in the previous lecture as we spoke, definitely we feel pride about IIT, but ITI is the backbone from where we get many of the students, young generation, providing technical assistance to the Industrial Development Corporation. And because of all such implementations, skilled labor was made available, which in turn gave boost to industrialization. Because of this, we have to understand that CCs started to grow. Yes, CP started to grow. And one best example of this is from our history chapter, in which we study about industrialization related to textile industry. In Mumbai, a suburb area where 11 near about, or more than 11 textile mills were set up. Keep it in mind, 11 or more than 11 textile mills were set up. This mill in Marathi is known as Girni. This mills in Marathi is called Girni. And because of this Girni available in that area, there is Girangaon. Girni che gaon manje Girangaon. So that area, which was otherwise a village, now slowly converted into an industrial area. And because of this industrial area, all the thousands of people who come from various parts of Maharashtra started settling out there. It became a suburb of Mumbai. Today it is a suburb of Mumbai. But now neither Girnis are there nor these peoples. Yet it is full of population. That means today the pressure of population is more in this area. These Girnis or mills, textile mills, then there was some other reasons that they shifted towards Gujarat, and today Gujarat is the textile hub. But when we study about how, because of industrialization, cities started to grow. Next example is Nagpur, which is right now going on. Mihan project. Mihan, a small village outside the Nagpur area, city area, is being targeted to be developed as an industrial development center. And because of this, multinational companies, national, international companies are being given permission to set up there. Water, transportation, electricity, skilled labor is being provided. But while doing so, many foreigners as well as from other states, high skilled working class people comes there for employment. Now naturally, these are the people who come from other areas to settle down there till they are in work. And while doing so, in the span of 10, 20, 30 years, they are now not ready to go back. This is how population starts increasing. And because of this, Nagpur is now entering as into a span of as a mega city. After Mumbai, Pune, Nasik, Aurangabad, it is turn of Nagpur, that Nagpur is converting itself into a mega city. Definitely, it will put pressure on many of the resources. Water will be needed at the most. It's an essential commodity of everyday life. Also, the road transportation. So naturally, even though it's a village, Mihan, as we speak about, yet transportation facilities will be provided by government. And naturally, along the roadsides, trade will start developing. This trade in return will create many opportunities for employment through various sectors to various peoples. We know that employment can be generated into primary, secondary and tertiary sectors. So because of this, the people who are not directly engaged with industrial development yet will be there working for their daily livelihood. The pancharwalas, the small chai dukan, apart from that masala, pani masala, these are just an example, but also the grocery, small areas or units where or the squares where we will find auto rickshaws, even other commodities that will be provided, and these employments will again put pressure on that area for population development. So what is the other side? The other side is that villages are now being deserted. People in the village area are easily or attracted towards the city life, and majority of the people who get education, educated people, population is now moving in search of employment towards the city life. This is how cities are increasing in number. Span of city is also increasing. It's not only that because of population, but because of migration also. Yes, population of India definitely is increasing, but population's role is rather less in the development of rural and urban areas in terms of people migrating or moving in search of job. And it is here that we find many of the villages have the population, but population do not reside in village. Now, this is how the villages are becoming desert. People are not ready. People means younger generation students are not ready to reside in villages. So that is one of them. Also the main part, second, that is mechanization. Mechanization and technology. Machines at the most are being used. Person getting small job. Anyway, for example, as we speak about Nagpur and Bihar, a person living in the central part of Nagpur gets an opportunity to work in a factory at Bihar, and he comes and goes, that is up and down, from his residence to the working place. For some days he will adjust himself, and then suddenly will go for a bike, a car, whatever it may be. But transportational facilities will, as been developed, will necessitate the need of, and these needs will be in terms of vehicles, maybe 2-wheeler, 3-wheeler, 4-wheeler, but these vehicles in turn again will need petrols, will need necessary equipments that will keep them intact, and that will be the increase in generation of employment opportunities. Opportunities will be provided to the younger generation to provide all the necessary. Apart from that, even this is the urban area, but as well as in rural areas, we find that tractors nowadays are being used. Machines are being used for irrigation purposes, sprinklers, drip systems. That means dependency on person, dependency on people is rather decreasing. And mechanization or even technology, use of technology is increasing. Because of this, definitely work output is better, more. But at the same time, because of the use of technology, less people can provide more work. And this in turn also requires the maintenance, the machines, the technologies that is being put to use from time to time requires maintenance. And for this maintenance, mechanicals are being made available. For this mechanical, shops are there which provide spare parts. And for these spare parts, again, transportation becomes necessary, because each and every product is not necessarily being well equipped or produced in that area. When we speak about Akola, when we speak about Nagpur, though both have MIDC, the necessity fundamental needs of the MIDC always are not being created in Akola or in Nagpur. So naturally, from outside, these spare parts are being purchased, and in that way, the slowly mechanization, technological equipments or industrialization, business, trade goes on increasing. People becomes more dependent. But when all these things are going, when we see that a center that was just a town, now converted into city, and city converted into mega city, for example Mumbai, for example Pune, or even Nagpur. When we study all these centers as a growing centers of urbanization, we have to understand that there are both sides of this, positive as well as negative. They have their advantages. Advantages in betterment of the nation. In terms of nation, yes, increase in economy develops the GDP of the nation. As the GDP of the nation, that is gross domestic product of the nation, increases, it gives opportunity for the government to provide many of the necessity, fundamental necessities which we all need. And for that, we will study about this. But before that, we have to understand that apart from all these things, one bigger section is migration. Migration plays a major role. Migration, that is people move from one place to another in terms of job opportunities. Till now we saw that. Because of education, people, as they are well employed, they move to one place or other wherever they need better job or gets better job. There are also people in India who move from their villages to a city for a specific time period. After that, they again move back. These are the people who do not have their regular shelter, home, places in the city, but in search of job opportunity. Now see why it is. Since migration is of various types. One is from rural to urban. Second is urban to urban. And third is state to other states. And then country. Other countries. So this is interstate and this is international. Migration is due to various reasons. One, people who move from rural area to urban area, maybe for employment, maybe for medicine facilities, maybe for education, or even for trade. A farmer in the village gets his crop, comes to the city, sell it, and again go back. For a day, he is in the city, but moves back. A person getting better equipped in terms of finance, a farmer who is gaining much more money from his farms, will spend more money on education of his children. So his children will move to the city. And in city, they will be there up to the completion of their education. So rural areas to urban areas, maybe in terms of education. Sometimes it happens that a person living in village comes to Okola for medical facilities. But medical facilities cannot be provided at the 11th hour always. And he will be asked to move to maybe Nagpur or some other big city, big centers. As moving there, for example towards Mumbai, he will have to stay there for month or long. Now, residing for the specific time period in that city is also a part of migration, but in medical field. So, we can get that some are temporary, some are long lasting. And once a person who gets an educated, becomes an educated person from the village, gets job opportunity at any other center which is outside his own district, for example, person from a village, Apollo district village, gets an opportunity because of his higher education in Bangalore. He becomes an engineer and gets opportunity in Bangalore. He will move in Bangalore till the end of his service. This is how rural to urban are. Also, there are times that during agriculture, after the harvest season, that is January, February, or even sometimes March, but in April, May, June, there is no work in the farms. And to get rid of, people move towards city life. Or sometimes it may happen that even during the rainy season, sometimes it happens that there is no work provided to many of the workers in the village. So they move towards city for work. Whatever work they do, But after a span of time, they return back to their own village because work opportunity increases during the harvesting season. So this coming and going for 2 months, 3 months, 4 months is a temporary type of migration. Once a person who has moved towards, for example, as we saw that a person from village comes to Akola, gets highly educated, becomes an engineer and gets a job in Bangalore, moves to Bangalore, settle down there. Now, the next generation he is having is not ready to come back and reside in village, neither he. These are the people who find their opportunities at the best in city life. So that is also means migration. But there are also migration urban to urban. Students property from Akola city for higher education moves towards Mumbai or some other areas. Sometimes they even go to other states and sometimes even outside India, but for education. So that is urban to urban. Sometimes it happens that for medical treatment, people from Akola moves towards Nagpur, Pune or Mumbai. Urban to urban. Akola, students of Akola gets job opportunities more in Nagpur, Pune, Aurangabad, Nasik, Mumbai. Urban to urban. Students from Akola can get job opportunities outside Maharashtra, that is maybe Ahmedabad, Bengaluru, as we spoke, Hyderabad, Chennai, or even Cuttack, Kolkata, Delhi, Chandigarh. Now these are the centers. Apart from that, there are also many, or even Indore, Bhopal. These are the centers which are outside Maharashtra. So urban to urban, but state to other states. That is interstate. And then we come to know that many students from India move outside India for higher education to various universities of the world. The world recognized universities give admission to such students, and that is international. But this is only for the student. Same is in terms of medical facilities, same is in terms of trade, same is in terms of various modes where people go and come back. Many times it happens that they go and settle. But being a native of one place, residing in another place is termed as migration. A person who moves from his own original land and settles down in other is termed as migration. Reasons may differ. So may the types. Then we come towards the effects of urbanization. Because of the higher population ratio, yesterday we saw that specifically in a square kilometer, more than 300 persons residing is termed as, we term it as urbanization. But this urbanization is very high in Delhi, in Mumbai. There are other places, definitely density may differ. But these people put pressure on many of the resources, and so we have the effects of urbanization. First, definitely advantages. India has its own history. India has its own culture. Even today we follow it. But because of industrialization, because of the change in policy since 1991, living lifestyle of the people of India slowly change. How it changed? People moving from one area to another and finding job opportunities, residing there, have to adjust themselves in manifold activities. They have to adjust themselves. The rent of the houses, the area in which they may get the rented house. From there, as they have to move to the other sides, the people who are in touch with them or in contact with them, all of them are from different areas, different sectors. It's not just as we believe and it happens. So, the first is social harmony. After 1991, as we saw that the pace of urbanization slowly started to increase, and it increased to a great height in 2011. Up to here, the cities or the urban centers, which were only 3,600, converted to near about 8,000, that means 5,000 urban centers developed in India, where the areas, because of the migration, may it be of one or the other side, but because of this migration, these people comes there and You know, as a student, we all know how Kota is famous for all over India. Not over India, not only India, outside India also. Kota has become a center of education worldwide. And because of that, people in Kota gets many of the employment opportunities, but giving their houses on rent. So, because of this, students moving from all over India for higher education, IIT students, gets settled there during their educational period. Similarly, if once they get their education completed, they get job opportunity. May it be outside India or in India. But as they move to a higher or metropolitan cities for their job opportunities, they settle down there. Now from here begins social harmony. Social harmony means people of various groups comes together. Now how is it? It is not a pre-planned idea. It just happens because of the economic policy that the government of India adopted in terms of globalization, free economic policy. Various people started getting job opportunities. Now these people moved to the other areas, and because of the stress, because of the pressure of population for search in search of residentials, the houses or the bungalows now started converting into apartments. Easily we can understand this. The areas, the houses are being demolished, the bungalows are being totally demolished. Apartment is being made. In an apartment, definitely according to the area and according to the means the area that will be having a population growth, apartments are being constructed. In an apartment, there are near about 14, 15, 18, 20, 22, 50 or more than 20 to 50 families as far as we in Apollo are concerned. Bigger the city, bigger will be the families. Multi-storied buildings in the name of apartments will be constructed. All these people do not belong to the same caste, same religion, same language, same region. And now all the people will have to adjust themselves there. This adjustment is the root cause of social harmony. These people is the, and the best example of this we can see in many of the TV serials. Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma is one of the example where different peoples, a Sikh family, a Marathi family, a Gujarati family and some others are living there. Is an example. Similarly, we can see this in Apollo also. There are many apartments which belong to various religions, various language, various caste people, even the peoples outside Maharashtra. Maharashtrians as well as outside Maharashtrians come together and live there. But at the same time, they enjoy each and every functions that is made, be religious or social. This is social harmony. Second, in the name of people coming there having high proportion of education as well as economic prosperity, modernization takes place. In every city, we find certain areas that are well equipped. There is a means roads are well modern. Street lights are available always. The sewage system, water sewage system is well most advanced. And because of this, that areas is, as we call them, posh colonies. These are the luxurious centers. In the name of modernization, they develop very fast. And to cope with them or to in retaliation, other areas also starts developing. Slowly, center develops. Now, because of the various government schemes, that is Swachh Bharat Abhiyan or even smart city, we find modern type of amenities being provided. Nagar Palika or Mahanagar Palika provides transportation services. Also, there are various other motives, that is, as we call them, government hospitals, PSCs. Also, market areas are developed. Apart from that, as far if we have to find all these things in Apollo, we find that the vegetable market, the golden market, even the iron ore market, apart from that, the grocery market, the food grains market, these are the names accordingly. We find that many of the shops, many of the centers are well developed, and from there, whatever one needs is being provided. So modernization. Amenities and facilities, we come to know that as far as Akola is concerned, that Akola is very well developed in terms of medical field, in terms of educational field. Also, sportsmen from Akola are now coming at the state and at a national level. Some of the students of Akola, which are too similar to you, contemporary to you, are well-known persons in various fields. May it be boxing, may it be coco, may it be cricket, also football. Akola was well known for hockey. Now maybe again it will be so. Because of the Krida Prabodhini or because of the facilities that are provided to the students or the amenities that are being facilities that are being provided to the students, they come up at the district, division, state and the national level. So this is all that is making the modernization or urbanization as an advantage. At the same time, there are also disadvantages. We also call the ill effects. What is the ill effects? Definitely, slums are increasing. Because slums, Jhopadpatti. Because of these slums, diseases. Because of this slum, the slums do not have all the amenities and facilities that other areas of the city gets. And because of this, because of lack of amenities and facilities, slums are the areas where poor people reside. And these poor people are facing many or multiple problems. Definitely, slums are also the reasons of migration. Slums are also the reasons of migration, but do not have their own residential areas. And they adjust themselves. Even because they are illegal, they do not have the permission of the government to settle down there. Facilities are not being provided by the Nagar Palika, Mahanagar Palika, Nagar Panchayat. And so they become the centers of disease. One. Second, traffic jam. Traffic jam is the most favorable problem nowadays everyone is facing. Roads that were constructed some 10, 20, 30 years back are now being smaller in content. Vehicles are more. People go out for various job opportunities or whatever the work they carry on day to day life. And then there are traffic jams. This traffic jam is responsible for pollution. More the use of petrol, diesel or the oil products, more will be the pollution. Air pollution, water pollution, sound pollution, even the excessive use of chemicals is also a part of pollution, becomes a part of pollution. May it be in agriculture, may it be in our day-to-day life. The smallest example one can give is of use of the dye or various products that to keep oneself update, we use them. And in this sense, slowly, because of the ammonia as one of the most important ingredients, its ill effects are seen. So these are the areas or these are the chemical components which makes the pollution more hazardous. This pollution becomes more active during the winter season. Especially we see that in Delhi and suburb areas of the Delhi, schools are being closed after Diwali or particularly November, December for near about a month. And that is because of smog. Smog plus fog. Fog definitely is a natural phenomenon. But because of the pollution cannot get at a higher elevated place and gets mixed up with fog. It becomes smog. And this smog is hazardous. Pneumonia is the beginning of it. And definitely, being a hazardous, small children, old people easily becomes prey to them. So pollution is because of water pollution, because of air pollution, because of sound pollution as we comes to know, because many, even in the home we see the television sets, sitting in front of the television sets, the volume gets higher. Or if we have the mobile handset and we try to increase the volume of your earphone, you will find that warning comes after a specific decibel that more sound may harm the ears. But to get an enjoyment, but to enjoy that thrill, we increase it. And then deafness is an ill effect of one of the conditions. Definitely, apart from that, one of the biggest is crime. Crime, all the people do not get employment. unemployed people are not ready to die. So they struggle, and their struggle is the beginning of crime. Bigger the city, bigger the slum, more will be the crime. As we speak about the slums, they are in Mumbai. Well-known personalities all over the nation or even the world are the people from this region who have named themselves. And because of this, crime ratio, not only in bigger cities, even in the smaller cities, even in Akola, rises just because of unemployment. Nowadays, the students who are highly educated and do not get jobs for a longer duration are not ready to lead a life without employment, and so a new type of crime is coming, that is cyber crime. It's because of net facilities, the mobiles, or particularly the computerization. The higher the technology, the higher will be the rate of crime. And it is in that sense. Price rise is one of the most important, according to the demand and supply of the market. If the supply reduces, suddenly price rises. There is a price hike. Nowadays, it has become a trick of the trade that even if there is abundant of the products available in the market, they are being hoarded to hide them for a specific time period. And the best example for this you can see is since Shravan month of the Hindu calendar in India to January in the Christian calendar, the prices goes on rising. May it be oil products. Or even the soap, the colors, there are many other things because of the festivals that arise from after every 14 days, 15 days. People need all this sugar, grocery, as well as certain articles which are of the need of that celebration are rising. Now, all this becomes a hazardous or main disadvantages of urban centers. If we read the text, we can find some more examples. Or even if we move around our lifestyle, we can find such examples available in our vicinity, in our areas. Hope you will understand all this. Thank you.